What makes Zengo more secure than a hardware wallet? And what does it mean to have a self-custodial wallet with no seed phrase vulnerability? We're going to talk about that and more over the next 15 minutes or so, so you can better understand how Zengo works, what technology Zengo uses, and what allows for Zengo to have such an incredible statistic. Zero Zengo wallets have ever been hacked, phished, or taken over, now with well over 1 million customers around the world since we launched the wallet in 2019. So let's jump in. So when we talk about secure self-custody, there are really two main issues to discuss. The first is secure storage, and the second is secure recovery. You want to know that your crypto is going to be safe for the short term and for the long term, and that if you're ever changing your device, upgrading to a new device, or you lose your device, you can always still gain access to your crypto. So a traditional crypto wallet uses a thing called a seed phrase. We'll talk about it more in a little bit, but it's like 12 or 24 words generally, and it represents a private key, which is a very important private piece of information that's a long string of numbers and letters. If anybody gets access to it, they get access to your assets. That's why it's so important that it remains private. Well, if Zengo doesn't use a traditional private key or seed phrase, what do we use? Well, we use a technology called MPC, which stands for multi-party computation. We'll talk about that and differentiate that from a traditional private key-based wallet. Now, a normal wallet uses those seed phrases to help with wallet recovery. Because we don't use a seed phrase, instead we use three-factor authentication for secure recovery. We'll explain how that works and why it's more secure than a seed phrase. Let's jump in first and talk about MPC. And I actually have a question for all of you. I would like for you to guess, over the last 10 years, how much Bitcoin and Bitcoin alone do you think has been lost or stolen because of seed phrase mismanagement? $10 million, $100 million, maybe $1 billion? Well, this statistic is sort of ridiculous, but what we expect and assume is about $250 billion has been lost or stolen because of seed phrase mismanagement. That is $250 billion. Think about it. Over the last 10 years, people who have been using Bitcoin tend to be early adopters, cryptographers, security-focused people. If they can't secure their own Bitcoin using seed phrases, how can we expect the regular person to do that? That's why we need a better solution. And that's because seed phrases are a massive vulnerability. Remember, a seed phrase is generally 12 or 24 words. Each seed phrase is unique and it must never be shared, copied, or stored somewhere online so it doesn't get stolen. Unfortunately, people make this mistake all of the time. These are scams that we see asking people to input their seed phrase to help with quote unquote wallet recovery. Now, you and I might know that this is a scam, but regular people don't, and that's why we continue to see them. This is my favorite version. Look, this individual probably had a hardware wallet. They thought that their seed phrase would be secure. They kept it in their pocket. And what I assume happened is they were stopped. The police officer pulled this piece of paper out and the body camera captured a photo of the seed phrase. You can bet that there are no longer assets inside of that crypto wallet. Let's talk about how a traditional wallet works, and then we'll explain how Zengo works. And of course, this is a simplified version, but you see kind of three steps. Step one, your seed phrase and your private key. Step two, using that to kind of unlock a transaction. And step three, on-chain, the transaction is accepted. Inside of your wallet, which in this case is on your mobile device, you have your seed phrase and you use that to approve things. But the issue is, this is a single point of failure. If you have malware on your device, whether it's your phone or your computer, that seed phrase can get drained, and we see that happening all of the time. It's easy to steal and it's really difficult to secure. Now let's talk about MPC and the difference between this cryptographic approach and a traditional seed phrase. First, it's worth noting MPC is not a new technology. It's been around for a number of years, mostly at the institutional level. So companies like Fireblocks, Coinbase, PayPal have been using MPC, multi-party computation, to custody hundreds of billions, if not trillions, of dollars. Meta was actually one of the first companies to join the MPC Alliance, of which Zengo was a part. Zengo was the first consumer-focused MPC wallet, bringing this advanced technology to average people so you and I can also securely self-custody without stress. One of the reasons why Zengo is such an appropriate name for this wallet, right? Now, security is in Zengo's DNA. The company was established in 2018, but for the first year, we focused on building the cryptographic background and the security infrastructure before we launched Zengo in 2019. Zengo has a brilliant research team called Zengo X. It oftentimes gets invitations to security conferences. It finds bug bounties. It's presented at Black Hat, which is the most prestigious security, cybersecurity conference in the world. And it's worth noting that Zengo actually has one of the largest, if not the largest, open source MPC cryptographic library on our GitHub. Go to zengo.com/research if you'd like links to get there. We also have a Telegram group focused on MPC cryptography. It's not Zengo focused. Feel free to join it. Again, zengo.com/research. Now, let's talk about how Zengo works and differentiate that from a traditional wallet. Again, you see, first of all of the cryptography happens in step one. Whatever happens in step one is then sent to kind of the blockchain, and then the blockchain approves the transaction. But let's focus on what really matters right now, which is step one. So in a traditional wallet, you have a single point of failure. Zengo does not have that. In our MPC model, we use a two of two system with two secret shares, the personal share and the remote share. Now, something magical and pretty complicated happens behind the scenes the first time you create a Zengo wallet. So when you start the process after you download the app, one thing happens in two locations simultaneously in different ways. Your personal share is generated on your mobile device, and your remote share is generated on the Zengo server. The two shares are then locked and cryptographically linked and secured in a way to make sure that a hacker, if they try to inject some code or inject some communication, aren't able to. This ensures that the two shares can speak with each other. When the two shares compute together, right? Multi-party computation. The result of that computation is equivalent to what a traditional wallet does, a traditional private key or seed phrase-based wallet. But the beauty of the system is, even if a hacker is able to somehow get access to your personal share, they still don't have the remote share on your remote share on the Zengo server. And vice versa, if they're somehow able to get access to your remote share on the Zengo server, they still don't have your personal share on your actual device. This makes the system an order of magnitude more secure than a traditional hardware wallet. Remember, a traditional hardware wallet, a traditional software wallet, these are single factor wallets with a single point of failure. So you can see again, the personal share, which is the only share that can originate a transaction. The remote share is there to help co-sign a transaction. And then the blockchain accepts the transaction like it would any transaction. It doesn't know that this is coming from an MPC wallet versus a traditional wallet. There's no single point of failure with multi-party computation. When it comes to wallet recovery, which we'll discuss in a minute, the process is locked to you as an individual, unlike a seed phrase, which anybody, as soon as they get access to it, means they can use. And lastly, because these two shares speak with each other, there are secondary layers of security and advanced tech we can build. It's pretty cool. It's part of Zengo Pro, and we'll talk about that at the end. So one last time, let's look at the seed phrase on the left and your Zengo MPC wallet on the right. You see your seed phrase wallet with its single point of failure versus your MPC Zengo wallet on the right, no single points of failure. So that's what it means to have a wallet that's secure by default. No seed phrase vulnerability because of MPC. Now let's talk about how to recover this wallet if you're not using a seed phrase. As a reminder, seed phrase wallet recovery is vulnerable. And we shared this example of what a seed phrase is. If anybody sees this, they can access your wallet. So make sure to never show anybody your seed phrase. And again, this photo of somebody who thought that they would never show or share their seed phrase, unfortunately, it got out there and there are no longer assets in that wallet. Remember, with a traditional wallet, your seed phrase must never be online. Don't take a photo of it. Don't leave it in your drive. If you lose your seed phrase, there's no one to go to for help. And whoever has access to your seed phrase has access to your assets. I've shared this before, so you probably know the answer, but how many Zengo wallets have ever been phished, taken over, or breached? The answer is zero, right? That's because there is no single point of failure, because the system is a multi-factor system, not a single factor system, which both hot and cold wallets, hardware and software wallets, are, unfortunately. Now, we put our money where our mouth was. And in January of 2024, we launched the Zengo Wallet Challenge. We invited the world to hack a normal Zengo wallet holding 10 Bitcoin and a Pudgy Penguin NFT worth collectively around $450,000. Today, it'd be worth well over $1 million. So this is what happened. During this two-week bounty, we put the Bitcoin and the NFT into the wallet. We shared hints associated with the wallet's recovery. There are over 200 attempts to hack the wallet, but of course, and also luckily, because it was a stressful period for me, zero successful attempts to steal those assets. No other crypto wallet has ever done something like that, putting their money where their mouth was, on-chain for everybody to see. And that's the beauty of an MPC wallet like Zengo. So now let's talk about how to recover your wallet if you're upgrading to a new phone, if you're moving from an Android to an iPhone, or the other way around. So instead of a seed phrase, again, which is not locked fundamentally to anybody in particular, we use a three-factor recovery system. The first is your email address, something that you can access. You must have access to this email address. We don't care if it's associated with your official name or if you create a new email for this. We don't need to know who you are. Just make sure that you have access to this email. The second thing is what we call the recovery file. It's not a private key. It's not your secret share. It's not a seed phrase, but it helps with the recovery process. Go to zengo.com/secure. If you'd like to learn more, if you'd like a more advanced video on how this system works, leave a comment below and we're happy to create one. Lastly, you have something you are, which is 3D face lock. This is liveness 3D biometrics. It's protected by a $600,000 bounty that's never been cracked. What it does is create a liveness verification scan of your face that's then encrypted on your device and used to make sure that you are who you say you are when you're coming to recover your wallet. Now, this is technically not mandatory. It's optional, though it's highly encouraged, especially if you have significant funds on your wallet, because it locks your wallet to you, something that no seed phrase-based wallet can do. Now, Zengo is a self-custodial wallet, which means if you lose any of those three factors, we cannot help you recover your wallet. So make sure you always have access to those factors. We make you create those factors before you can ever put money onto your Zengo wallet, but you can also make sure that your recovery file system is as strong as possible. So you can add a secondary email, you can add your recovery file in multiple locations, and then you can also add 3D face lock backup of a trusted friend or family member if you would like to. And that's highly recommended. So we talked about MPC, we talked about three-factor authentication for secure recovery. Next, we're going to do my favorite discussion, which is what all of this enables, something that a dumb hardware wallet simply cannot do, which is advanced security and self-custodial tools. And we call that Zengo Pro. So let's talk for a minute about that. Remember, because you have these two secret shares speaking to each other, there's advanced security logic that's part of that conversation process. Think of it like account abstraction, or AA, on steroids for everything inside of your wallet. And it includes things like theft protection, an advanced built-in Web3 firewall, and legacy transfer, which was the industry's first on-chain inheritance-style feature for all of the assets inside of your Zengo wallet. Let's start with theft protection, which is my personal favorite. Think about it. Even if somebody knows the PIN code to your hardware wallet, They can access your hardware wallet and they can take all of the assets. If somebody knows the PIN code to your mobile device, they can access everything in your mobile device, whether it's your bank or your crypto. But not if you're using Zengo's theft protection. So what you do is you turn this on in the security settings. And what you can do then is, by using 3D face lock, decide when that engages to protect transactions. You could have it off. You could have it on for every transaction. Here's an example where you have it on for any transaction where the amount is worth $420 or above. And what it does is, as part of the approval for the transaction, force 3D face lock to authenticate you. Because again, 3D face lock only works if you are who you say you are with liveness biometrics. It won't work for your friend, for your family, for somebody who might know the PIN associated with your mobile device. The advanced built-in Web3 firewall is just like a stoplight: green for go, yellow for watch out, and red for stop. Because we wanted to make it simple to know if you should probably approve or not approve, or be wary of a transaction, that you're considering the approval. As part of this, you can also turn on theft protection for Web3 transactions. So if you have high-value NFTs, DeFi, this is a great option to make sure that you're only approving when you want to, and that it's you that's doing the approvals and no one else. And the last thing is legacy transfer, which a lot of folks have been asking about and looking for lately. Think about it. You want to ensure that your assets are secure for generations. It's really difficult to do that on-chain with a traditional crypto wallet. What are you going to do? You're going to give your seed phrase out? If you do, somebody can make a mistake. Somebody could steal your assets. Even if they don't want to make a mistake, maybe somebody will misplace your seed phrase and they'll know what's exactly in that wallet. But not if you're using Zengo and not if you're using legacy transfer. This requires no KYC. It's multi-chain, so it includes Bitcoin, of course, Ethereum, all of the layer twos, every asset that Zengo supports, and it's self-custodial. The best thing is you have full control. You can cancel it at any time. You can reassign it to someone else at any time. And nobody knows what's inside of the wallet until they eventually get access to the wallet, if the whole process plays out the way that you want it to. So here's a brief example of how it works. You assign a legacy recipient. You need to be a Zengo Pro customer, but they do not. They just need to be a Zengo user. And then you decide when the inactivity timer should get to zero. That could be as short as 4 months. It could be as long as 2 years. You decide when you consider your wallet inactive. To reset the timer to zero, all you need to do is open your Zengo wallet, and you'll get lots of warnings, emails, push notifications, and reminders before legacy transfer would activate. The last thing to share about Zengo in general is that, unlike I think every other wallet out there, we have live in-app 24/7 support around the world by real people who are standing by, and they have seen it all. A big part of security is education and knowing that you've got somebody there to ask questions if you're not sure. The number of times that we get questions around what a wallet address is, making sure to send to the right blockchain, these are incredibly important questions that many people might not think are that critical, but these are the building blocks to having a safe and secure and long-term relationship with crypto. So thanks again for listening and learning more about Zengo's advanced security and MPC infrastructure. If you have more questions or what you would like to learn more, if you would like us to do more in-depth videos, please comment below and share what you'd like. And as always, stay Zen.